welcome to another Toddler Tuesday. I am Miss Sarah. It's so great to be spending this time with you. This is our last story time session though for the summer. We'll be meeting at some parks, hopefully cross your fingers, in August for our story time in the park program. And then we'll resume with Toddler Tuesdays in September. I have a feeling that it will be just like this, but we will keep you updated. Let's go ahead and get started with our story time dice. Our frog. All right, remember, close those hands, close your eyes, close your mouth and say, mmm. Open your eyes, open your hands, open your mouth and say, ah. Mmm, ah, went the little green frog one day. Mmm, ah, went the little green frog. Mmm, ah, went the little green frog one day. And they all went, mmm, mmm. But we know frogs go sha-na-na-na-na, sha-na-na-na-na, sha-na-na-na-na. But we know frogs go sha-na-na-na-na. They don't go mm-mm-ah. Great job, everyone. Let's do that one again, or roll again. And we got the trolley. All right. Oh, Pittsburgh is big and Pittsburgh is wide. People hop on the trolley when they want to take a ride. It goes underground when they want to get around. And the trolley doors open with a big whoosh sound. And the people get in and the people get out. And the people get in and the people get out. And the people get in and the people get out. And the trolley zooms off. Whoosh. Great job, everyone. It's time to sing our thank you song for our grown-ups who help us every day doing five simple things. Sing, talk, read, write, and play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Growing readers every day. Let's do that one more time. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Sing, talk, read, write, play. Growing readers every day. If you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, clap your hands. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet. Stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet. Stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, stomp your feet. Stomp, stomp. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray, hooray. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray, hooray. If you'd like to read a book, have a listen and take a look. If you'd like to read a book, shout hooray, hooray! Terrific, everyone. So our first story today is called, The Watermelon Seed by Greg Pizzulli. Do you love to eat watermelon? It is one of my favorite foods. And a little known fact, when I went to summer camp when I was little, I was the seed spitting champion of Pioneer Ranch. I could spit the seed farther than any of my friends at camp. I haven't tried in a while though, I should. Oh, I love watermelon. Chomp, chomp, chomp. It's the best. Ever since I was a teeny tiny baby crocodile, it's been my favorite. Chomp, slurp, chomp. I like it for breakfast. I like it for lunch. I like a big salty slab for dinner, and I love it for dessert. I love watermelon. Gulp. I just swallowed a seed. I swallowed a seed. It's growing in my guts. Soon vines will come out of my ears. My stomach will stretch. My skin will turn pink. I don't want to be in a fruit salad. Somebody
Help me, please.
How do you think he's feeling? He might be worried and a little sad and a little scared.
Grumble, grumble. Oh no, I can feel it growing inside of me. It's happening right now. My stomach feels funny. Burp.
Oh, here's the seed. That was too close. No more melon for me. Never again.
Well, maybe just a teeny tiny bite.
Chomp, chomp, chomp.
Oh no. The end. If we look back at these pictures, how do you think our alligator friend is feeling in this picture? He looks awfully happy. He loves eating his favorite food, and he has a little bit of a smile. Still looks happy. How do you think he looks here? A little worried. He just ate that watermelon seed, and he's not sure what's going to happen. He's a little panicked, and he's really getting scared. He starts to worry that vines are going to grow out of his ears. Do you think vines could grow out of your ears? We've been talking an awful lot about using our imagination this summer. And sometimes when we use our imagination too much, it can be scary. Do you think he will really turn pink?
No, but I think he's worried he might turn pink.
Do you think he'll really end up in fruit salad?
No, but he's imagining that he's in fruit salad and someone might take a bite of him. That would be a scary way to use your imagination. And here, he looks awfully sad. How can you tell he's sad?
Yep, he has some tears. I think he might be scared because he's wrapped himself up into a ball. Do you ever wrap yourself up into a ball when you get scared? Maybe if you have a bad dream? But at the end, we know that he ends up feeling happy again. What a roller coaster of emotions. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. Lots and lots of feelings. Grown-ups have big feelings. And sometimes we have to remember that kids have big feelings too. And it's okay to feel worried or scared or happy or sad. There are so many feelings and they are all okay. Let's sing a song about a few of them. I have feelings, so do you. Let's all sing about a few. We get happy. Let me see your happy face. We get sad. Can you show me your sad face? We get scared. And we get mad. Let me see that mad face. I am proud of being me. That's a feeling to you see. He looks like he's very proud of himself. So we have happy, sad, surprised, and angry, and proud. Do you want to sing that one again? I have feelings, so do you. Let's all sing about a few. We get happy. We get sad, we get scared, and we get mad. I am proud of being me, and that's a feeling to you see. I know that sometimes we can worry and we can feel sad or scared, or sometimes we just have a yucky feeling in our stomach and we really don't know what it means.
that's okay too. The best thing to do is to talk to your grown-up about the way you're feeling, even if you're not sure. And grown-ups, talking about these feelings, singing these songs, and labeling our feelings helps our little one deal with that, because anything that's mentionable is manageable. So I encourage you all to talk about your feelings and share that with your kids. It's very important, and it takes away some of that scared feeling that they might have, not knowing exactly how they're feeling. All right, let's switch it up a little bit and sing If You're Happy and You Know It, because that might be one of my favorite feelings. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're grumpy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're grumpy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're grumpy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're grumpy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're sad and you know it, say boo-hoo, boo-hoo. If you're sad and you know it, say boo-hoo, boo-hoo. If you're sad and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're sad and you know it, say boo-hoo, boo-hoo. If you're surprised and you know it, say oh my, oh my. If you're surprised and you know it, say oh my, oh my. If you're surprised and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're surprised and you know it, say, oh my,
oh my.
If you're scared and you know it, cover your eyes.
If you're scared and you know it, cover your eyes.
If you're scared and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're scared and you know it, cover your eyes. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Great job, everyone. My two hands go clap, clap, clap. My two feet go tap, tap, tap. My two hands go thump, thump. My two legs go jump, jump, jump. My one body turns around. Then I sit quietly down. Shh. Great job, everyone. So we were talking about how sometimes our imagination can lead us to worry. And this book is called The Don't Worry Book by Todd Parr. Todd Parr is a great author that helps us deal with some feelings. So I would always recommend checking out his books if you want to talk more about feelings. Sometimes you worry. Ooh, ooh. Worrying happens when you think too much about a problem or feel afraid that something bad is going to happen. You might worry when you meet someone for the first time. When someone is being mean, when it is dark, when you are trying to sleep, or when you go to the bathroom, when you go somewhere new, or when you are all alone, or when you have too much to do. Grown-ups, I know we're all feeling like this right now. We have so much to do. You might worry when it rains. When you get sick or you have to go to the doctor. When watching TV. Or from looking at screens too much. Right now, the things that are on our TV screens can be pretty worrisome. You might worry when someone is being loud. Woof, bark, ow! When you go to school, or when you overhear some bad news. Worrying can make you really sad. But when you worry, try to do something to keep yourself busy, like talking to someone special, taking some deep breaths, visiting friends, wearing underwear on your head, or reading a book, dancing, exercising, squeezing a toy, or thinking about all the things that make you strong. And remembering everyone who loves you and takes care of you. Worrying doesn't help you. If you are worried, talk to someone you love about it. It will make you feel better. The end. Love, Todd. And I hope when you think about all the people that care about you, you remember I care about you too. And even though we can't be together, I think about you, my storytime friends, all the time. And I can't wait until we're together again. But even I get worried that it might be a lot longer than I had hoped. And when I start to worry, I have to remember to take deep breaths. When I used to bring my little girl to story time here with Miss Elaine taught us how to take deep breaths. Can you move your hands up when you breathe in? And take your hands down when you breathe out. We always called those Miss Elaine breaths. Let's try another Miss Elaine breath. Something else you can do is pretend that you have a flower. See my pretty little flower? Let's use our imaginations. Smell the flower. Now pretend it's a candle. Blow out the candle. Smell the flower. Blow out the candle. But you know what? Sometimes when we blow out candles, we blow really hard. And we want to blow nice and slow, kind of like when we're blowing bubbles. So maybe we can pretend this is a candle or a bubble wand. Let's try it again. Smell the flower. Blow a bubble, nice and slow. Smell the flower. Blow a bubble. I'm already starting to feel a little bit better. Another trick you can do is you can lay on the floor and grab a teddy bear. I'm gonna lay down here. And I'm gonna put my teddy bear right on my tummy. So when I try to take deep belly breaths, I need my teddy bear to go up and down. So I'm gonna breathe in and breathe out. Can you see my teddy bear going up and down? Breathe in, breathe out. So if you're sometimes laying in bed and you're a little worried, you could put your teddy bear or your stuffy, maybe it's a donkey, whatever your favorite stuffed animal is, place it on your tummy and watch it go up and down. All of these simple tricks might make you feel better. Whoops. We'll cut it in there. There you go. Is my hair back to normal? All right. So those breathing tricks might help you if you start to feel a little worried or a little scared or a little sad. All of those feelings are okay. What we need to do is try to learn how to cope with them. So whether it's a flower or a bubble wand or a teddy bear or a Miss Elaine breath, all of those things will help you feel better. And if all else fails, let's dance. You've got to shake, shake, shake your sillies out. Shake, shake, shake your sillies out. Shake, shake, shake your sillies out and wiggle your worries away. You've got to jump, jump, jump your jiggles out. Jump, jump, jump your jiggles out. Jump, jump, jump your jiggles out and wiggle your worries away. Great job, everyone. You can have a seat. You could probably add lots of different verses to that song, however you're feeling. I can't wait to have you share them with me when we're back together again. Bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. Stand up. Sit down. Stand up again. And turn around. And around. Bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. Hands on your head. Hands on your knees. When you get a cold, you might sneeze. Hands on your head. Hands on your knees. When you get a cold, you might sneeze. Bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. Elbows in front. Elbows in back. When you look like a duck, you go quack, quack, quack. Elbows in front. Elbows in back. When you look like a duck, you go quack, quack, quack. Bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. A bim, bam, bam, bam. Razzmatazzma. Tish, tosh, tish, tosh. Wallaby, woo. Whoo! Good job, everyone. And now it's time for our goodbye song. See you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. Give a hug, ladybug. Blow a kiss, jellyfish. See you soon, raccoon. Out the door, dinosaur. Take care, polar bear. Wave goodbye, butterfly. Great job, everyone. Now remember, use those imaginations to pretend you're at the beach, or that you've grown up to be a cowgirl, or that you're a doggy eating food out of the bowl on the floor, or that you're anything you want to be. But if that imagination ever starts to make you worry, smell the flower and blow the bubble until you feel better again. And hopefully we will see you all next month at our story time in the park. And if not, we'll catch back up with you on Toddler Tuesdays starting back in September. Have a great day.